today I'm going to talk about how I got 1600 stars in GitHub in 2 months of open source work. But first, I have a question for you. Have you contributed to any open source project? Please raise your hand. Yeah, just pick a typo. Please raise your hand. Yeah, cool. So if you haven't, I hope you will after my talk. So a little bit about me. I'm a creator of Jest Preview. Jest Preview is a library that gives you a visual debug experience when you're testing a front-end app. And also, I'm a co-member of patchofjs.org. It's a website that helps you follow the growth of the JavaScript ecosystem. And yeah, you can connect with me via Twitter or GitHub. This is what I'm going to cover. First, I want to cover what is Jest Preview and why I built it. And I'm going to go through what the struggle do I have to overcome when I build an OLS project, and what did I receive from joining the open source community. And lastly, I will give you some tips if you want to build your own open source project. First, what is Jest Preview and why I build it? I know that a lot of you guys you React, right, and you're front-end engineer. And if you ever write test in for a front-end app, it's kind of, yeah, we don't want to write test much, right? But when you write test and you experience some bug, you might experience this, like that you have to see the very long HTML in the terminal, and yeah, you just don't want to do it, right? So I think that what if instead of looking at the very long and boring HTML, I can visualize it in the browser. So I try, and yeah, I can do it. This is a very quick demo of, I have a test here. It's a React app. And when you render it and you do some action like click on it, and you just put the preview.debug, you can see the actual UI in the test. And this library, I built this library to solve my problem itself. So turn out many developers out there, they have the same problem, and yeah, they just use it, and they see that very useful. And if you have the same scenario, just give it a try. And I think I want to do a little bit more demo. Here I have a React app, and this is a very basic React app. It has a cow, and if you click on this, it's going to inscribe one. And I have a test that I render an app and click it six times. And I expect the cow have to be six. But if I add another line, so it's not going to be sick, right? The test will fail. But if you debug it in the test, you have to see a very ugly HTML. But I try to visualize it in the browser so you can see it easily. And many times you can debug you can spot the bug faster. Ooh, where are my mouse? Okay, so I want to share some struggles I had to overcome when building Jest Preview. The first one is difficult. So I show here is a style component. CSS module. Almost if you ever use CSS module, you know the syntax, right? It's very easy. Just import styles from the style module.css and use it. But when I try to support CSS module in Jest Preview, I have to work with much more complex code. But I learned a lot. The next one is take a lot of time when you build an open source project, and because when you build a project because there are no existing solution. So you are the one who try to resolve it. So sometimes it takes a lot of time. And especially when you have full-time job, when you return from work, you do not want to spend some time to do open source, right? So as I am now, I'm a full-time open source. I have always have to plan and to spend on open source. And one more thing is, one more struggle is that I thought if it's an open source project, many people will come to help you, but it's not really. And sometimes working on open source that you want to give up and archive the project, but whenever you reach that state, just remember why you want to start the open source software project in the first place. And one more thing is one more struggle is financially, because you just working for free. When you work at a company, someone pay you for you to write code. But when you work on the open source, you just do some kind of charity, right? So to solve this problem, if you just do it for fun, it's fine, right? But if you spend many time on this, you have to find something. Yeah, you can try GitHub sponsor. You can try some open collective or some kind of premium model, like you have a free version. But if your user want to have more support or have some more feature, you can charge them. The next thing I want to share, what I received from doing open source software. The first one is knowledge. I learned a lot. When I at my work, I'm a front-end engineer and I work mostly in React. I just know how to write components, write UI, and write, how to organize my component or how to make it more efficiently. But when I doing open source work, I have to know why that work and how that work under the hood. So I read a lot of source code. So my skill reading code and debugging skill of mine, it improved a lot. And one thing is that it's like a rabbit hole when you try to solve one problem, but you find some bug. For example, that I build Jest Preview, but I have to read a lot of Jest code, and I dig into the Viet core, and turn out I send them a couple of pull requests. So yeah, it's just a rabbit hole, and you have to learn a lot. And I know a lot about how bundler work under the hood and how they process CSS in modern application. The next thing is the opportunity. Just for 2 months of open source work, my project got nominated for the most exciting use of technology for an React Open Source Award. And yeah, it's very honor of me. And also, I got many company reach out for job offer. I think it's a good invest. And yeah, I have chance to join a conference and tech event like JSConf. Next, I know a great developer. In the past, I never thought that I'm gonna talk to many famous creator of my favorite tool. I have some favorite library like MSW, Mock Service Worker, if you ever use it, or React Hook Form. Yeah, I never thought that I'm gonna be friend with them, but when I dig into my open source work, yeah, I finally get to know them and many other developer, and turn out that they're very friendly and they will support you. Next, I know a great developer in person. In July, I attend another conference in Singapore, and I meet many great people here. Maya Shavin from Microsoft, Evan Gill, creator of Vue.js, and Tan Li Hao, he core member of Svelte. Next, and I have chance to meet you guys at JSConf Korea this year. And one thing that I received from doing open source software is that I received a lot of thanks. At a random moment in the day, some online guys told me that, yeah, your software just make my life easier, and thank you for that. And that's a feeling that I never get when I'm doing a 9 to 5 work. And yeah, I think that's the most rewarding. And next, so how to do that? So I am going to share some tips, some of my personal tips to build your own open source project. And I think there are a lot more, but I just picked some of mine. First is I think this is the most important question is how to choose an open source project to work on. And there are many answers, but in my opinion that you have to contribute to the project you use every day. If you want to build your own software, open source software, you have that software that has to solve your own problem. You cannot find some random project online and hey, I try to contribute to it, but it's very difficult to someone to contribute to a project that we do not have any context at all. So for example, that in the daily work, I use React hook form a lot. So I turn out I can contribute to them, and it's kind of my way to find and help the author and maintainer. Second one is file maintainer, because you know, building an open source project is very hard and stressful. So it would be easier for you to have someone to discuss technical and motivate you to continue the project. The next one is that if you release an open source project, do not start it at 1.x, because a new project is full of proof of concept and experiment, and things might get changed very quickly. And the semantic version, if your software starts with 1.x, it means your next version has to be backward compatible with the previous version. Otherwise, you have to inscribe to the major version, right? If it's a new project, I recommend that you just use the major version 0. It's for initial development, and anything can change, but the public API should not be stable. So you can see that many famous projects, but it takes a very long time to reach 1.0. For example, Svelte is very close to 1.0, but yeah, not there yet. And next is please use your own software. So when you use your software as a normal user, you can add more feature or you can adjust it to make it reusable. For example, when I build Jest Preview, all I want is I just want to put the HTML into the browser, that's all. But when the more I use, I add many feature to it, like the auto reload. Whenever I hit save, the test run finish and the browser reload out automatically. And the more I use, I have to work on code how to process CSS or image. Otherwise, it's just the plain HTML in the browser. And you can ask for feedback, because when you build your software can be subjective. And please ask your friend, your college, and your network that if they use your software, and you can give you some feedback. And after a while, maybe if your software show a kind of real pain point, people will come and watch out for the issue and discussion tab on GitHub. Next is learn from others. So do not reinvent the wheel. So when we build a open software project, there are many problems you have to solve that someone already solved. So learn from them, read their source code, and maybe steal a little bit, but remember to credit them. Picasso have a line that good artist copy, but great artist steal. So don't worry that sometimes you have to learn about other code. And my project have to learn many things from Viet, from Create React App, and many other projects. And next advice is you can write a good documentation. So because it's very easy for you if you build your own software, but people around the world, they have very different use case, and sometimes you do not imagine how they use your own software. So just describe what problem you're trying to solve, how the installation and usage, and what caveats they might encounter when they use your software. And it's very, if you prefer React, there are software called Docusaurus, and if you prefer Vue, you can use Viet Express, and this is my documentation. I try to make it very easy to understand and how to use it. You can run a demo on there. You can how to plug it into your code. And next, you build a great software, but please share it with the world. I think Twitter is the most amazing platform you can share something with the world. And maybe you can write some blog posts and share it with others in the tech event like I am doing. And yeah, last but not least, that contribute to open source today. And I hope you will have a lot of fun and learn a ton when doing open source software project. And thank you for attention. And this is a link to Jest Preview. And if you are a front-end engineer, maybe you struggle debugging tests, give it a try and give it a start since it's free. So thank you very much. And the slide available here. Yeah, thank you very much.